After my studio taking a fairly big hit by epic flooding last week, or the last few weeks, right? I'm excited to announce that I'm starting to get back. Like, the flooding actually came up to about here, man. It destroyed this room, but I managed to get a lot of the stuff out. So anyway, thanks for your support over the past few weeks. Anyway, today's video, it's really awesome actually, as the goal is to show you how to deconstruct any DJ set and to notice how the people that inspire you play. So when you turn up to DJ at events and parties, you can model those techniques and you can sound as good, if not better, than your inspirations, okay? So let's jump in. So the other day, I was at the gym, I was doing some Thai boxing, okay? And I was rocking out to a Fisher set, okay? And I noticed the majority of the time he was playing the full track and simply mixing over the outro. But these days, when watching DJs play on YouTube, it seems really popular to mix, like, you know, 10 tracks in 10 minutes, apply lots of effects, you know. And honestly, it can be confusing for people. It's like, well, which way is better? Now, in truth, okay, it depends on who you're playing for, okay? So for instance, okay, if you're playing for an online audience that maybe has short attention spans, sure, lightning fast transitions and effects are a really cool way to showcase your skills, and it keeps your audience engaged and probably increases your watch time, okay? But when playing live, it's probably more important to create atmosphere. And I remember I was running clubs for about 17 years, okay? And let's say I've heard heaps of DJs play, and you learn about how much of each track to play very quickly. And I remember sometimes you might drop in a track, and let's say, you know, you drop it in, gets a really good response, but then you just play like 30 seconds of it before going to the drop of a new track. Now, mixing like that, like I said, for an online audience where it's not a dance floor, it's awesome. But when playing live, man, people are like, oh my God, you know, let's say you went to a Fisher set and he played like 30 seconds of Losing It before going to something else, people may actually be disappointed. So just remember, when you turn out to play live, it's all about track selection and how you arrange your tracks to create atmosphere. And by the way, I teach all this massively in my Club Ready DJ courses, and all the tricks and everything you need. But yeah, I like to get people club ready, and then you can build on that too. So it's about getting those rock solid foundations first. So let's say you want to DJ like Fisher, okay? Not produce, but actually DJ like Fisher, or any DJ for that matter, right? The very first thing I'd do is I'd start listening to live sets. And then once I find one that resonates with me, I'd go across to 1001tracklist.com. And I'd type in the name of that set. So in this case, it'd be Fisher at Creamfields, and I'd see what comes up. Now, the beauty of 1001 Tracklist is not only does it list the tracks in the order that they're played by that artist at that event, but quite often they even tell you where the transitions occur. And from that, you can also figure out how much of each track was played and in which places that DJ chose to do their transition. Now, this is great, as let's say you want a DJ like Fisher. You can actually like start by downloading all the tracks, you know, put them in a playlist, find the transition points, and then you can start listening more closely to what kind of techniques they're doing. Like, how are they transitioning? How are they doing it? And put it this way, by doing it, okay, here's the outcome. Let's say you're turning out to play at a club and you're as good as Fisher, okay? And you're hearing what he does to kind of like taking from his experience on how much of each track to play and how he arranges it. When you turn out to play, say you're like Fisher, man, your headline material, you're going to be killing it. People are going to be loving you, as opposed to DJs maybe mixing too quickly. You've really got to find that balance. It's all about, I say this to my students all the time, it's all about finding the balance between how much of each track do you play. It's all about, you know, finding songs that go well together. Again, all taught in my Club Ready course. Okay, now personally, when listening to Fisher's Creamfields set, okay, I'm hearing a combination of EQ work, okay? I'm hearing some filter just to emphasize the ones, and I'm also hearing him mixing most of the time over the end of the chorus, perhaps some drop replaces here and there, okay? Now, by the way, I did a video probably a couple of years back, it's one of my big ones actually, where I broke down how to mix tech house. That's actually gonna have a lot of these techniques. So if you haven't, I'll link that in now. You definitely wanna check that out if you haven't already. Okay, so let's jump in. So let me show you some of Fisher's techniques. But mind you, I have no above shot of Fisher actually playing, okay? So this is me kind of taking educated guesses by what I can hear. And I think that's perfectly okay, okay? So firstly, let's look at the first transition Fisher does into his own track, You Little Beauty. So what I did, I heard some EQ work, I heard filter, like emphasizing the changes, and also a volume drop one bar before the new phrase kicks in of the new track. So let me show you me reproducing that Fisher transition now. Okay, transition two now. This one's fairly easy, okay, and straightforward, which it kind of proves my point, okay, and that is it's not about tricks when playing live. It's about mixing in the right tracks to get a response from your audience, okay? So for this transition, you can actually see where he hits play. So he hits play exactly 16 bars after the last drop, and then what he does is he keeps the new track playing underneath and basically drops out the exiting track two bars before the drop to allow space for his famous like pre-drop vocal to play on its own. So let me show you that now.
Get out the way, my feet wanna go dancing. out the way. My feet wanna go dancing.
Now, transition three. This is my favorite transition in the set as he brings in the crowd favorite, Losing It. Okay, so people are probably there for it. And what I found, okay, this is pretty interesting, okay, because he kind of pulls back the energy with the previous track, okay? So that means people, everyone there, perhaps getting a little bit bored, okay? And you can see that from the video. And then what he does is then he drops in the intro to Losing It hard, okay? And obviously then it's the signature track, people might be there for it. It's almost like they're there getting a bit bored, then it came in the intro, and then all of a sudden it's playing, and then it drops in, and obviously everyone kind of loves it, okay? So, okay, I think the key with this one is you don't want the intro coming in underneath. When you've got a powerful intro, you know what I mean? He kind of dropped it in. It was like it came in strong. Okay, so let me show you that now. Now, this set was created almost 3 years ago, and I'll be honest, the whole time I spent decrafting these transitions and making this for you, I was just inspired to jump on and create my own version of this mix, okay? And that's, you know, that's the beauty of watching the pros play live and even immersing yourself in the clubbing culture, as it inspires you, okay? And in truth, I'm now inspired to do my own like Fisher inspired tech house set, but you know, I think I'll aim to do better, you know, like, you know, so let me know if this is something that would interest you. Perhaps I'll bang out one over the next coming weeks. Maybe everyone got a live stream coming up, so you know, I could play that maybe. Let me know. Anyway, if this is inspiring for you, but you're still fumbling your way around your DJ gear, and let's say you lack the foundations or the confidence needed behind the decks to make this happen, stop wasting your time. Check out my Club Ready DJ courses, okay? And I'm certain my courses will have you DJing as good as the pros within a few weeks, 100% guaranteed. See, I teach all these skills plus so much more. And once you're ready, right, the package even includes an advanced performance course that, in my opinion, is going to have you DJing better than the pros, okay? And then once you're ready and feeling confident, perhaps you can make the jump into production, okay? But the good thing about learning to DJ first is You're going to have a solid understanding of music theory, and you're also going to know what people respond to, like when playing to dance floors. Okay, so when it comes time for you to try your hand at producing your own music, you can do what everyone else does and follow these simple formulas. Again, these formulas honestly become more and more apparent the more you DJ. It's just like, you know, I can get you there, I promise. Okay, anyway, hopefully you found today's video helpful. Thanks again for tuning in. Please like, comment, and subscribe to help the channel grow so I can keep releasing content for you. I love what I do, and I'm grateful I can share weekly insights to help you up your DJ game, okay? So it's good to be back. I feel a little bit out of practice on this one, but thanks for your support. I'm excited to really build momentum now. I've got a lot of ideas. Okay, thanks guys, see ya.